Very good morning to everyone. So today we'll be start with module 3 of engineering economics. So in this module we have two parts, that is equivalent annual worth comparison and rate of return calculations. So by the end of this module you will be able to take decisions on different investment options based on the annual equivalent worth comparison, and you will be able to determine the rate of return for different investments. So these are the two things you'll be able to do by the end of this module. It is mapped to the CO 3 and 4 of the subject. Now coming to the previous module, module 2, you learned present worth and future worth comparison, right? So basically those were economic, those are the different techniques that we use to measure the economic equivalence. So what do you mean by economic equivalence? When can we say that two investment options or two assets have same equivalence? That is when the two things are equal if they have same effect. In economic point of view, they should have same value in terms of money. That is what it is. So what do we do to measure economic equivalence? We use different methods, right? That is, what are the two methods that we use? So the methods that we use are present worth comparison, future worth comparison, then annual equivalent method, and interest rate, internal rate of return, or IRR. These are the four different methods that we use for the methods of comparison. So in all these cases, we consider three factors. That is, we see the value for money. In that is amount of sum, then time of occurrence of the sum, occurrence of the sum, then interest. These are the three factors of value of money that we consider when we are checking for economic equivalence. Okay, so we saw the different methods of comparison. So on what basis do we compare? We compare different alternatives in order to take decision, different alternatives based on these factors of value of money, and we take decisions, that is whether to accept or reject any investment method. That is what it is. So why do we need to compare different investment options? So that we will be able to say whether this which option is better from an economic point of view, so that we can take decisions logically based on the profit that we receive, or based on the amount that we have to spend. Based on that, we will be able to decide which investment option we need to choose. That's it. So we saw the different methods of comparison I mentioned earlier, that is present worth, future worth, then annual equivalent, annual equivalent method, then internal rate of return. These are the four methods that we will be seeing as different methods of comparison, in which first two we already learned in the module 2. Now module 3 we will be seeing first part, that is annual equivalent worth comparison, or equivalent annual worth comparison. Okay, so now coming to annual equivalent worth comparison. So what exactly it is? Annual equivalent worth criteria. It provides basis of measuring the worth of an investment by finding the equivalent payments on an annual basis. That is, we have say present, we have say P or F. That is, present worth is given or future worth is given. And what do we do? From this value, we will find its equivalent annual payments. A. From P, we will find A, that is annuity. Equivalent annuity that will return the P. Okay. So, that is, with this annual worth method, all the receipts and disbursements occurring over a period are converted to equivalent uniform yearly amount. So, equivalent uniform yearly amount is what in general we consider. But what we can do is, based on our requirement or based on the what is given, like we need to find it as quarterly or semi-annually or monthly, we will be able to convert it. So it is not just yearly, it can be annually, semi-annually, quarterly or monthly, depending on the requirement. So it is not just yearly, but whatever the receipts or disbursements that we have as P or F, what do we do? We will convert it to A, or we will try to find out its equivalent A. So what did we do in present worth? Present worth, we were given F or annuity. F was given or annuity was given. And we found its equivalent. We found its equivalent present worth. In future worth, what did we do? We were given P or we were given A, and we found its equivalent F, that is future worth. Now here, what is that they are giving us? They are giving us either P or F. P or F or different disbursements or receipts or both combined, and we will find its equivalent annuity A. That is what we are finding here. Okay. That means, so why are we doing this? Why are we doing? Because basically, if we are able to find out what is it that we need to spend a year, or what is that we will receive by the end of a year, will give us an understanding of, okay, yearly we are receiving so much, yearly we have to spend so much. That means in 20 years we will need to spend so much every year. So that is like a yardstick. It is given here, like it is a yardstick on how will we measure the progress of our investment. That is what it is. Okay, so annual equivalent amount is the net sum of annual receipts and annual disbursements. So equivalent is the net sum of annual receipts and net sum of annual disbursements, and we present it as AE for an interest I, which is equal to, I think I've written here somewhere, okay, AE is nothing but present worth of I given for into A given P comma I comma N. It can be F also, but in this case we are considering present worth. Okay, so that is what it is. So depending on the value of annual equivalents, we will decide whether to accept or reject an investment. Now, what is it that we have? We prefer, in this cases, what is the preferred type of cash flow diagram that we assume, or what is the preferred inflow and outflow of cash? It is nothing but a repeating type. That is, here you can see repeating type cash flow is nothing but 0 and 1 is repeated for 2, 3. It is repeated for 3, 4, for 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on. It will keep on repeating. Why is it like that? Because what are we considering here? That is, the pattern of inflow and outflow of cash flow remains the same. That is what we are assuming here. Okay. So, now coming to the next part. That is, okay, we will learn in the next video.